clavicles are below the ribs. Okay? And cardiomegaly, apparent cardiomegaly will be seen in APV, not in the PAV. Generally, for to see the lungs, we go for PAV. For APV, we go for bone structures. Okay? APV for bones. Ribs and everything we will see in APV. PAV we go for heart and this lung. Okay. First, whenever we see the X-ray, we have to see how is the, is there any means proper radiation is there or not. If proper radiation is there, means we cannot see the ribs, vertebrae behind the heart. Cardiac cell hoti, we cannot see the prominent vertebrae, we cannot see. Okay, if we are able to see, means overexposed film. Other features of overexposed film means there will be blackening of the lungs without any bronchovascular markings. If bronchovascular markings are there, means it is normal exposed. Okay, and we cannot see the behind heart, we cannot see the vertebrae. Okay, and also we have to see for the if it is underexposed, there will be haziness of the lungs. Hyperemic means increased vascularity will be seen, as if increased vascularity is seen. Overexposed, overexposed means all over the lungs it is black color. Okay, that is, and also ribs will be seen, vertebrae will be seen. If vertebrae are seen and blackening of the lungs is overexposed film. Normal exposed film means adequate exposure. Means adequate exposure means we cannot see the vertebrae behind the heart and the bronchovascular markings will be
visible.
Okay? And underexposed means haziness of the whole lungs will be there. Proper centralization. Centering is normal or not? By seeing the scapular and clavicular articulation distance. Articular distance. Spino-clavicular articular distance. If articular distance on both sides is equal, we say it is proper centering. If it is distance between the right clavicle and this one is there, means decreased. Length is there, means the film is lateralized to that side. Okay. Now coming to the what we see. We have to see first exposure, proper centering is there or not. Then coming to the ribs. If clavicle is there or not, we have to see. Any erosions of the clavicle. If clavicle erosions are there, means we have to suspect bronchogenic carcinoma and multiple myeloma. If and also we have to see for the kyphosis, scoliosis. First we have to see middle of the this one, spine we have to see for any kyphosis or scoliosis. Then go for the clavicle presence or absence, some syndrome is there. Clavicle absence, cleido dystocias, something it is there. If absence of clavicle is there, we have to suspect that. And any erosions of the clavicle means bronchogenic carcinoma. Then coming to the ribs, we have to see if there is any overcrowding of the ribs. If overcrowding of the ribs is there, fibrosis or collapse we have to suspect. Any widening, distance between the two ribs is enlarged, means emphysema we have to suspect. Any same thing, bone erosions are there or not, we have to see. If bone erosions are same, bronchogenic carcinoma, multiple myeloma. One other thing is we have to think of hyperparathyroidism. Clavicle means only those two. If ribs are there, means hyperparathyroidism also suspected. Notching of the rib is there or not. Notching of the rib is there, means coarctation of aorta. any fractures of the ribs are there. Okay. Then absence of ribs, any bifid ribs are there or not, we have to check for the bony cage. Okay. Then coming to the lungs. Lungs, we have to see the, we have to divide the lungs into three zones according to the lower part of the second rib. We have to divide into three zones, upper, middle and lower zones. It is not correlating with the lobes of the lung. Okay. Upper zone is from the apex to the lower border of the second rib. That is the upper zone. From lower border of the second rib to lower border of the fourth rib is middle zone. Coming to the lower zone means till down. Okay. Mediastinum. Now coming to the mediastinum. Lungs we have to see if there is any vascularity. Vascularity, bronchovascular markings or any haziness, anything we can be seen in this part. Okay. Bronchovascular markings, soft tissue means lung tissue, parenchyma. How is the lung parenchyma and how is the bronchovascular markings are seen in the lung. Mediastinum. Coming to the mediastinum, we see the trachea. Trachea is midline or not, we have to see. Okay. If trachea is shifted to any other side, we have to think opposite side is. If left side is a problem, left side is a problem. Trachea is shifted to right side, mean, right side means?
Tension pneumo.
Any hydropneumothorax, pneumothorax, pleural effusion, anything filling the opposite side. So it will shift the trachea to the opposite side. If there is collapse and fibrosis, same side it will be shifted. Coming to the heart. Heart, we have to see the borders of the heart. Left side, we have to see the aortic knuckle. Aortic knuckle, then coming to the pulmonary bay, means formed by pulmonary artery. Then this is the concavity. Pulmonary bay is concave. Then right left atrium will be straight line. Then left ventricle will be bulging, convexity. Okay. This convex bulging is aortic knuckle. Then concavity, slight concavity. This is because of hilum is there. That's why it is showing that. Otherwise, concavity will be there. That concavity is pulmonary bay. Then straightening will be left atrium. Then bulging is convexity is left ventricle. Right heart border is formed by superior vena cava. Then right atrium. If this is also left atrial appendage, we will say, not the left atrium. Okay, this right atrium, superior vena cava, right atrium. Okay, if there is concavity or straightening of the aortic knuckle is seen, means old age changes will be there. If filling of the convexity of the right convexity of the pulmonary bay is seen, means pulmonary hypertension is we have to suspect. Okay, if there is bulging of the left atrial appendage is there, means there will be mitral stenosis, left ventricular, left atrial hypertrophy is seen. In which conditions we have, you have to suspect. Then if right atrium is, right ventricle is enlarged, the apex will be right ventricle. Upwards and outwards. Okay, apex will be shifted upwards and outwards. If right left ventricle is enlarged, means it will come outwards and downwards. Okay. Boot shaped heart is seen in right ventricular hypertrophy. Okay, because the transverse diameter will be enlarged. In left ventricular hypertrophy, oblique diameter will be enlarged. Then coming to the cardiophrenic angle and costophrenic angle. Costophrenic angle will be seen, the angle formed between the diaphragm and the rib is the costophrenic angle. And the angle formed between the heart and the diaphragm is cardiophrenic angle. Heart and diaphragm. Costophrenic is ribs. Diaphragm and ribs. Okay, we will see both sides. Okay. Cardiophrenic angle will be seen here, right side of the heart. And also cardiothoracic ratio. The cardiothoracic ratio should be half of the length of the, how will you measure the length of that, this thing? Lowermost part of the chest in PA view. This is the lowermost part of the chest in PA view. This divided by the half of length of the heart. The length of the heart can be measured by taking the spinous process. Vertical line is drawn from the spinous process. Vertical line is drawn. From there, from here to maximum diameter we have to take. And from here to maximum diameter is here. In middle of the line, spinous process, from here to here, it is the maximum diameter of the heart. From middle of the this thing to here, it is the maximum diameter of the left side of the heart. So we have to calculate both these and divide by total diameter of the lowermost part of the chest. That is the, that gives the cardiothoracic ratio. Normal cardiothoracic ratio should be 1:2. 2 means 2 parts of this, half part of, 1 part of this, or 0.5:0. Okay, half of the chest. Okay, 1:0.5. Coming to this soft tissues, we will say, whenever we say X-ray chest PA view, we have to say it is a chest X-ray PA view showing with adequate exposure, proper centering, adequate exposure, with bony cage normal. Bony cage, no abnormalities. No bony abnormalities. Then coming to trachea. Trachea is in midline with normal lung fields. Normal lung fields with cardiothoracic mediastinum. Mediastinum is normal in size with no cardiomegaly. Cardiothoracic ratio is normal. Okay. Then costophrenic angle, cardiophrenic angle are normal with no soft tissue abnormalities. Okay. To describe a chest X-ray PA view, we have to tell it is a chest X-ray PA view with the proper exposure or adequate exposure, proper centering, with no bony abnormality. Okay. Then trachea. Trachea is in midline. Trachea is in midline with normal lung fields, with normal bronchovascular markings. Then we have to comment on the heart. Heart is normal with no with normal cardiothoracic ratio. Lungs lo cheppali, trachea cheppali, bronchovascular markings unnai kada, idgo idi
this is a normal X-ray.
ఇక్కడ దాకా ఇది 2-3/3 డివైడ్ చేయాలి. 2/3 దాకా వచ్చిందంటే బ్రాంకోవాస్కులర్ మార్కింగ్స్ నార్మల్. వెన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఓవర్ హైపర్మిక్ మీన్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎక్స్టెండింగ్ అప్ టు ద పెరిఫరీస్ ఆఫ్ ద హార్ట్ లంగ్. సో టు రిక్వైర్ ఆక్సిజన్ టు టేక్ ద ఆక్సిజన్ దే ఆర్ వాస్కులర్ మార్కింగ్స్ ఆర్ ఇంక్రీస్ టు టేక్ ద ఆక్సిజన్. ఇట్ ఈస్ యూటిలైజింగ్ ద హోల్ ఆఫ్ ద లంగ్ టు టేక్ ద ఆక్సిజన్. సో ఇన్ విచ్ కండిషన్స్ వి రిక్వైర్ మోర్ ఆక్సిజన్, there the bronchovascular markings are increased, like pulmonary edema, asthma, bronchiectasis, anything. Other conditions will be seen. Bronchiectasis means bronchovascular markings will be there with the air bronchogram will be there. Partial filling of the alveoli with the pus or fluid. This is air bronchograms. Okay? With normal bronchovascular markings.
This is a normal X-ray.
Normal X-ray. Okay? Right side. Ippudu, how do you suspect this dextrocardia like that? If I have shifted this one, main thing we have to see the right symbol also is important. whenever you see the x-ray, right side, you identify the x-ray film showing right, and the whole of the maximum part of the heart is on the right side. Generally, the maximum part of the heart will be on the left side. Okay? Situs inversus is different. The diaphragm, fundus, everything will be shifted. So, we cannot identify that. If we have to see this also, right side of the heart also is important. Means right side of the chest, where we are localizing. Then only we can identify dextrocardia. Okay? See, this is upper lobe apex consolidation is there. Means what are the this is what is you suspect, what do you suspect with this
right sided
pleural effusion, because this angle is obliterated. So then we will think of axillary area, it will be shifted up upward. Yes, S line should be there. If S line is there, why it is S line is there?
Capillary.
Trachea is the midline only. What are the conditions where trachea is in midline and there will be massive pleural effusion?
Collapse.
Collapse. If pleural effusion is existent with the collapse of the lung, there will not be any shifting in the trachea. Okay? Trachea appears to be in midline. But we will see massive pleural effusion. Okay? Or massive consolidation. Any massive consolidation also will have this type of feature. Okay? There will not be any shifting of the trachea. We can suspect one is massive consolidation, whole of the lung is involved, or pleural effusion with collapse of the lung. So causing, if collapse of the lung is there, we have to see slight homogeneous opacity followed by slight linear transparent line will be there. Translucent line will be there. Then we can think it is a collapse of the lung. Lungs has come collapsed and filled with fluid. Okay. So this may be possibility of massive consolidation, because there is no linear line. And somewhere it is air-filled areas are there. So it is a massive consolidation. Okay.
Ma'am, this the ribcage, the vertebrae is very clear, no, ma'am. Why is it not APV, ma'am? And even the ribs are very clear.
That's what APV, overexposed film will have this type of feature. Okay? Ribs are prominent. And also, we have to see inspiratory film or expiratory film. If posterior ribs are 10 ribs and anterior ribs are 6 ribs, then it is said that it is a inspiratory film. Normal inspiratory film. Okay? This is also. Tell me. Consolidation. Air bronchograms are there. Somewhere fluid collection with air spaces are there. So it is air bronchogram is there. Let us suspect non-homogeneous opacity showing a consolidation. Because trachea is in?
Center.
Center.
You should not mention lobe by
Zones we have to mention.
Zones.
Not radiologically we mention about the
zones.
Not the lobes. Okay? Here you see, trachea is right side, left side, left. What is this film? Trachea, see. To the?
Shift to the right side.
So, this non-homogeneous opacity will be fibrosis. Okay? This is fibrotic patch. Okay. Collapse means
it will be more black.
Blackness will be there, and some area of homogeneous opacity will be there.
And there won't be bronchovascular markings.
Yes, bronchovascular markings will not be there. That is the main feature of collapse. Okay. Lung has already shrunken, and there will not be any, only the air spaces will be there. Okay. చెప్పండి.
అది కార్డియోమెగలి. ఓకే
కార్డియోమెగలి. దేర్ విల్ నాట్ బి ఎనీ అప్స్ అండ్ డౌన్స్ ఆఫ్ ద హార్ట్. బల్జింగ్, టోటల్ బల్జింగ్ ఇస్ దేర్. అప్స్ అండ్ డౌన్స్ ఆఫ్ ద హార్ట్ ఆర్ నాట్ దేర్. హార్ట్ నకల్ పల్మరీ బే ఎనీథింగ్ ఇస్ నాట్ దేర్.
కార్డియోమెగలి.
దిస్ ఇస్ పెరికార్డియల్ ఎఫ్యూషన్. ఓకే కార్డియోమెగలి. వెన్ యూ సస్పెక్ట్ సమ్ features of up and downs are there,
okay.
Some part of the heart is enlarged, huh?
So
some part of the
enlarged
and some others are normal only, huh? Then we have to check for the cost of cardiothoracic ratio, then we will say that it is a cardiomegaly. Here it is globular heart, pear shaped heart. The you have to mention that heart, pear shaped heart. You mean pear shaped heart?
This is pleural effusion.
Pericardial effusion.
Pericardial.
Ma'am, cardiac tamponade, what is it?
Huh? Difference cardiac between tamponade and...
That is theory part. You have to learn. What is pulses, alternance will be there, that difference will be there.
On ECG.
Okay? ECG you are not
on
having.
On X-ray, it can be
same. X-ray, if we want to say it is a pericardial effusion, the X-ray finding, for the X-ray finding to be appear, means minimum 250 ml of fluid should be there, then only we can see in
X-ray.
Cardiomegaly features will be there, this pericardial effusion feature. By 2 days ago we can identify till 15 ml also, but X-ray finding, for to see for X-ray finding we should require 250 ml of pericardial fluid. Okay, for pleural effusion 300 ml to obliterate the postophrenic angle, minimum fluid should be there, means 300 ml for pleural effusion. This is cardiomegaly. One, tell me, I have told you, no? Whenever you see the X-ray, what are the features you have to tell? Tell me. Hello. చెప్పండి. చెప్పండి. అవును, మిషన్ అది సమ్మరీ వస్తుందండి, నాట్ స్టేట్మెంట్
రావట్లేదు.
ఆ ఫోన్ లైన్తోనే ఉంది. With adequate exposure,
proper
centering, ఇది కొంచెం డివైడ్ కదా,
రైట్
రైట్ సైడ్.
What do we check for centering, ma'am?
Centering. That's what I am asking. This is spino clavicular articulation distance. That you have to check. Capillo articular clavicular articulation distance. This.
Spino clavicular articulation distance.
Yes, yes,
yes. Go close.
Left side zyada hai to? Right. It is right side, it is. The distance is reduced here. So it is deviated to the right side.
Right.
Spino-clavicular articulation distance. Okay?
No bony abnormality.
No bony abnormality. Next. With no bony abnormality. Trachea is in midline. Bronchovascular with normal lung fields with a decreased bronchovascular
margin.
Kyunki the blood circulation will be shifted.
Cardiac borders are not clear.
Cardiac borders, there is cardiomegaly. The ups and downs are not visible.
So it's pericardial effusion.
Pericardial effusion. Okay.
How can we say about cardiothoracic ratio?
We cannot identify the aortic knuckle, pulmonary bay, we cannot identify. So it is a globular heart suggesting a the cardiothoracic ratio is increased, suggesting pericardial effusion. Cardiothoracic ratio should be increased. And also there are no demarcation. Aortic knuckle, pulmonary bay, we cannot identify. It is a globular heart suggestive of pericardial. Okay. Other soft tissues, costophrenic angle, cardiac, and also one important thing, the cardiophrenic angle becomes more acute because like this it will bulge, no? The cardiophrenic angle will be more acute. This is a sign called as a Koch's sign. Here, where we see the
acuteness
of the
cardiophrenic
angle, which is prominent in the
pericardial
effusion. This is called as Porter's sign. Okay, followed by we have to say for the cardiophrenic angle, costophrenic angle, and soft tissues. Soft tissues are normal. Next. This is the, what is this? Shoulder drooping is there.
Right side.
Right side. Tell me. Check on.
Shoulder drooping is there on the right side. Costophrenic angle is on the left side.
On the right side.
Costophrenic
angle on the right is obliterated.
The lower zone
on
the right.
The lower zone.
Ian sign is it? Why it will happen? Capillary suction between the two layers of the pleura. Causing dragging of the fluid towards the axilla. Capillary suction between the two layers, which drags, or hello, my chicken sir.
Pleural effusion.
Pleural effusion. Inkokati pleural effusion is pleural effusion with associated tracing is there. If it is straightening, not like this sign. If it is straightening is there, means what is suspected?
Hydropneumothorax.
Why? From upwards air will be there, down fluid will be there. So straightening of the opacity will be there. Okay? That is hydropneumothorax. In hydropneumothorax, upper airway will not have any bronchovascular markings. Okay? If hydropneumothorax is there, compared to the, you have to see both sides, then only you can compare. So for someone, people bronchovascular markings are less, like that will be there. Go to compare both sides. If bronchovascular markings are compared to left side or right side, it is there. Decrease means you have to think of pneumothorax. Okay.
X-ray the word. X-ray the word.